Today we are going to discuss maximum likely hypothesis for predicting probabilities. Okay, last class already we discussed mean square error hypothesis mean and also another hypothesis also we discussed. Now today we are going to discuss maximum likelihood hypothesis for predicting probabilities. So let us consider the setting in which we wish to learn a non-deterministic functions, that is nothing but a probabilistic functions, that is f belongs to 0, 1, which has a two discrete output values, that is either 0 or 1. We want a function approximator whose output is the probability that f of x is equal to 1. In other words, it is 0. Learn the target function. The target function f is x belongs to 0, 1, such as, so show that f of function f of x, the probability of f of x is equal to 1. We can learn f using a neural network. So that is use of brute force learning algorithm. Previous lectures we already discussed. If you want for your reference, you can go through that video. Use of brute force way would be to first collect the observed frequencies of ones and zeros for each possible values of data x, and then train the neural network to the output and target frequency for each x value. Okay. Now, what criterion should we optimize in order to find a maximum likelihood hypothesis for function f in this settings? Based on this criteria, the first criteria is first obtain the expression, that is posterior probability p of d by h, and next criteria is assume the training data d is of the form d is equal to x1, d1, x2, is a pair of instances, data x1, d1, x2, d2, and so on up to xn, d1, where di is nothing but observed either data 0 or 1 for the function f of xi. Both xi and di as a random variables, and assume that each training example is drawn independently. We can write the posterior probability p of d by h as p of d by h is equal to pi product of, this is nothing but pi is nothing but a product rule, pi of I is equal to 1 to m p of x1, already I told we are going to write the expression p of d by h in terms of xi, di by h. So that is nothing but a data set in the hypothesis. So you can apply the product rule here. P of d by h is equal to product of I is equal to 1 to m p of here di by h, da by h, xi into p of xi, product of this one. Now we can find the probability of p of di by h, xi, that is nothing but a, so that will be xi when data is equal to 1, it is 0. When data is equal to di is equal to 0, that probability value is 1 minus h of xi. Re-express it is in more mathematically manipulated form. So I'm going to substitute that one. So probability of di by h, xi is nothing but a, so h of xi power di, otherwise 1 minus h of xi power 1 minus di. Either it will be 1, otherwise 0, based on that di value. So now I'm going to consider this is equation number 4. So substitute equation number 4, p of di by h, xi probability function to obtain the equation 5. So p of d by h, the initial function is p of d by h is nothing but product of I is equal to 1 to m h of x. I'm going to replace this probabilities. The previous one we already told. So this is nothing but a p of di by h, xi and probability of xi. So we are going to replace that one. Now the first one is nothing but a h of xi into di, 1 minus h of xi power 1 minus di, and next probability product of these two. So this one and this one. So this already I am going to replace with p of di by h, xi is nothing but a, we already got using the probability function. So I am substituting, so that you consider as the equation number 5. Now we rewrite an expression for the maximum likelihood hypothesis. So h of ml is nothing but a maximum likelihood hypothesis. H of ml is nothing but already we know argument of arg max h belongs to h, h belongs to h p of d by h. Already d by h is nothing but this is nothing but product of that one equation number 5. We are going to substitute. The last term is a, so in this what is the last term? We have is a it is constant independent of h, so it can be dropped or discarded. So I'm going to discard this p of xi and then I'm going to rewrite this equation and consider that equation is nothing but a equation number 6. It is easier to work with the log of the likelihood. So I'm going to substitute the logarithmic. So if you substitute logarithmic, so this can be di into log of h of xi. So we are going to replace this product rule and we are writing as a summation of I is equal to 1 to m di into log of h of xi. So if you apply the logarithmic, di into log of di into log of h of xi plus 1 minus di into log of 1 minus h of dx. So it will come as a summation. So this is equation number 7. So equation number 7 describes the quality that must be minimized, that what maximize in order to obtain the maximum likelihood hypothesis in our current problem. Okay, so our main aim is nothing but we are going to maximize this in this expression to get the maximum likelihood hypothesis. Okay, now gradient search to maximize the, so what we have to do for that? So we are going for the gradient search to maximize likelihood in a neural net. So derive a weighted training rule of neural network learning that seeks to maximize g of h, using gradient ascent. So I'm going for the gradient search to maximize that to get the maximum likelihood hypothesis. So consider the gradient is gradient g is nothing but a pair of h comma d is given by the vector of partial derivatives of g of h comma d with respect to the various network weights that defines the hypothesis h represented by the learned network. In this case, the partial derivative of g of h comma d with respect to weight wjk from the input k to unit j is d by dt of dou. Partial derivative we are writing as a dou by dou with respect to wjk of g of h comma z. So if you differentiate this one, we'll get is a summation I is equal to 1 to m dou z h of d by dou h of xi. Next expression, if you differentiate, means dou by dou wjk of h of xi. Okay, now I'm going to apply a partial derivative for this one. So dou of di, if you apply h comma d, dou of di ln of h of xi plus, again for the second one is 1 minus di into ln of 1 minus h of xi divided by dou h of x with respect to h of x first term, and second term is same as such only. Now if you simplify this one, means if you simplify the above equation, we'll get d minus hx divided by h of x into 1 minus h of x, and second term will be as such only. Now suppose our neural network is constructing from a single layer of a sigmoid function. So we are going to substitute with the sigmoid function, then dou by dou wjk of h of x becomes the sigmoid function sigma of xi into x of ijk. Now I am going to substitute the sigmoid function is nothing but h of xi, 1 minus h of xi, and second term will be as such, where xijk is the kth input of the unit j for the ith training example. Same thing, d of x is nothing but derivative of the sigmoid function. And finally, substitute this expression in the first initial expression to obtain the simplified expression. Okay, derive that constraints with a gradient. So dou by dou dj of g of j by is nothing but I'm going to replace this one is with di divided by h of xi into x of ijk. Okay, now because we are seeking to maximize rather than the minimizing. Minimizing the posterior probability p of d by h. So we form the, so for that we are we consider as a gradient descent or ascent rather than the gradient descent search. So if you go for the gradient ascent, so it's not possible. So we are going for the gradient descent search. On each iteration, in the each iteration of the search, the weight vector is adjusted in the direction of the gradients using the weight updated rules. Okay, wjk is nothing but initially we are considering as a wjk is the initial one. Now for maximizing the error, for maximizing maximizing rather than the minimizing, we have to update the weights. The new updated weight using this formula WJK is nothing, WJK plus rate of change of WJK. So WJK is nothing but, how to calculate WJK is nothing but mu of summation I is equal to 1 to m di minus h of xi into that previously what we assumed, where where mu is the smallest positive constant that determines the step size of the gradient, gradient ascent such. Okay, now it is interesting to compare this weight update rules to the weighted updated rule used by, you can use any weight updation algorithm here. Backpropagation algorithm is the backpropagation algorithm is it gives the more accurate algorithm, better than the other algorithm. So we selected the backpropagation algorithm to minimize the sum of the square error between the predicted and observed network outputs. So the backpropagation algorithm updates the rules of output unit weights and re-express using our current notations. Okay, WJK is nothing but the same thing what you use. Initial weight is nothing but WJK. We are going to update the weights using the backpropagation WJK plus rate of change of WJK. So WJK is nothing but this is the expression we are using to update the weights. Okay, understood? This is the maximum likelihood hypothesis. Clear? Next class we will see the remaining topics. Thank you.